Thank you so much, Pyra. Yeah, well, in this one, I want to say depressing result for the Copenhagen Wolves, seeing all they have done, and very, very positive for H2K in terms of bouncing back. Let's start by picks and Manzo, because the Copenhagen Wolves, great adaptation. You called it, first pick Ari, and then the Hecarim coming in for Youngbuck were the right choices.
It's like, it seems like Europe hasn't really adapted to like the themes on Holy Grail thing, so they're kind of stepping back to the old picks like Ari, and Ari is still a fine pick. Slightly nerd, but still fine. But I think what sticks out the most is the fact that they brought up the Hecarim, and the Kalista as well is perfect for freeze, and I think they punished H2K by blind picking Kog'Maw into a player that plays Kalista. I think that's really, really dangerous. Sure, they won the game, but being that far behind is something you don't want to be.
Yeah, against a better team, they may not have been able to bounce that far back. And also, like, the Diana mid, quite unconventional. Didn't expect that from Ryu first time in the split, and it worked out in the late game. But the early game, it was completely the Wolves' favorite.
Yeah, didn't work out in the early game. Let's get the replay up on the screen from the first two kills, as it was, well, cooperation with Airwax coming in the mid lane to start it off.
You know, this is the whole thing that Copenhagen Wolves had to do. They picked early game champions, they picked strong laners, and we always knew the Wolves had the ability to make great plays. Airwax even interrupting the body slam there was well played. So Sora's going to pick up the kill on Lulex. The most impressive thing is the kill that's about to follow. Youngbuck has struggled all split long. He's only been playing tanks, and we're seeing him on a carry, and he out 1v1's Odawande, who is one of the most hyped top laners coming into the split. This impressed all of us on the desk, and it actually set the Wolves up really strongly to follow up, but unfortunately just wasn't enough.
It's like, I think in this game specifically, I'm really happy that both Airwax and Youngbuck stepped up immensely in the early game, which was required. They just couldn't really close it in. And the fact that like Youngbuck getting a soul kill on Odaamne, that's something that should go down in history, I think. And the fact that Airwax just completely smacked Lulex in the jungle was really impressive from both of them,
yeah,
even though they lost.
It wasn't like, again, hark back to the stats and the numbers we keep talking about. At 20 minutes, H2K were down. This is only the second time in the last 14 games that they were down in gold at 20 minutes. The number 3,700 gold down. Copenhagen Wolves were unable to punish. They floundered, they flustered, they didn't play the map. And again, stats, Copenhagen Wolves' average win time is 52 minutes. It would have taken another 32 minutes for Wolves to close this game out. You don't give Maokai, Kog'Maw, Diana another 32 minutes, otherwise this result happens. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, definitely.
And great adaptation by H2K. Although there was one TP in the mid lane from Odawame that was a little wonky. I think they were finding their footing right after. They just do get incredibly decisive in the team fights. Let's get one of the decisive team fights up on the screen. Also showing how freeze, how much CS he is up. It doesn't really matter.
We can take a look here. Youngbuck is pushing in on Kassing. Once again, like, even though like Youngbuck is overcommitting here, Kassing is playing it out perfectly. I think in every team fight in this game, he's just been playing it wonderfully. Odaamne is zoning out freeze once again. Youngbuck taking too much damage because he's simply overextending into the team fight. He's basically providing with no pressure because freeze is not doing damage during this time. And Ryu once again doing phenomenally in this team fight, zoning out. And freeze, once again, the fed guy on the team, is not doing any DPS. And that's a problem with Kalista. She falls off immensely compared to Kog'Maw.
Yeah, and one thing I also want to highlight, in the previous game, Copenhagen Wolves ran the Jaguar comp, and they were picking incorrect team fights, maybe showing a little bit of inexperience in the team comp. This particular series, Youngbuck playing Hecarim, he had two or three teleports that were kind of like awkward, again showing inexperience. The way this team fight started was with Youngbuck TPing in, with an engage on Slaughter Shallows, and the team fight was not great for how the comp was supposed to work. Mm-hmm. Copenhagen Wolves, they figured out what they need to change to win games. They just don't have the experience to do it.
To close that, and if they, you could argue if they haven't been able to figure it out in the past 9 weeks, will they be able to from game two to game three? Another thing I do want to reiterate is what you were saying during the game as well. And we all see Kasing's influence, the individual. We always say it's not a team that plays around individual strengths, but two individual players, both Kasing and Ryu, are playing maybe their best games yet.
I can only say that I think Kasing is the best support in Europe by far. And the fact that Ryu is stepping up, like, he's playing, like, he did some mistakes these games, but he's still playing very, very well. Like, he realized that the team was behind and he was willing to take those risks I didn't think he would be able to do. So I'm kind of leaning to giving him the first place in mid lane as well now.
All right, there we go.
It's hard to argue. Yeah. These games, Ryu, the last two team fights, finding Freeze, shutting him down, Kasing saving everybody over and over. I high-five and support that call.
Yeah, and final thoughts about maybe the first two games we've seen. for the Copenhagen Wolves, what do? You pull out that Hecarim that you haven't shown before, and you do so well in the early game. You get your AD carry on his favorite AD carry. You get first blood for your mid laner, but it still doesn't work out.
Well, I'm actually, like, this is the kind of game, if you think of the Copenhagen Wolves and HK matchup, this is the kind of game you kind of expect. Copenhagen Wolves winning early game and not being able to close out. I think that's the main reason why most of us lean towards HK in this matchup.
Yeah, I agree. And I think if you're Copenhagen Wolves, you have to just throw all caution to the wind. You're down two games in the series. You've still got a spot in the summer split. There's literally nothing to lose. You've been thoroughly beaten. Now throw all of it out the window and just go crazy.
Yeah, we'll see if they do that in Game 3. Before we take a break, though, to set up for that Game 3, we want to take a minute to hear from you guys at home. As earlier today, we asked you which quarterfinal team has the best chance at going to the finals. And wow. Well, here's what you think in any case. Our first tweet comes from @VictorKawe. Gambit all the way. They can keep their composure and go for a hot streak. Each player's performance can inspire each other. You called Unicorns of Love as the outsiders, though.
I did. And, you know, we talked about it and think about it. Gambit as a team, I think, have the ability to get to the finals, but they need to fix a lot of trouble. And what we've seen from them, every single one of their lanes has stood out at one time, which is why they're in the playoffs. Now they need all of them to shine together to make it to the finals.
Yes.
Our second tweet is from @RockTheCasbah. H2K has the coach of the split in their back pocket and the individual player talent to adapt to a multi-game series. I couldn't have summed it up better, Jacob.
That was perfect. Yeah. We should hire this guy. But like,
we
I
get your first
him.
Time on the desk.
Sorry. You can't hire people on your first day on the desk.
But then again, back to his point, like, I completely agree with him. H2K is filled with talented players. We've been talking about Kassing and Ryu so much. And Proly, of course, coach of the year for EU. Coach of the split, probably coach of the year as well, seeing as I've said that H2K is a team that is going to continue to grow simply because already they're trying to adapt to the highest class of play, which is really elegant, and I like the way that kind of play style is coming up.
And the most durable way of playing and winning in the end. And as always, we appreciate you guys chiming in, so keep doing that. Tweet @LESports and use that #LCS, and we'd like to hear from you throughout the entire day. Now, as we head into a break, the question is, can the Wolves avoid getting swept in three? We'll find out right back here in just 3.5.
We went into this best of five knowing very well that we were probably going to lose the first one, with the purpose of scouting them. Now it's our turn.
The flash and the dash, but it gets blocked. Soren is there.
Nice
flash
play.
Charm. This is going to be first blood. There's no tower to fall back to. Freeze Unlimited coming in as they take down Hjarnen. They rip through Lulex.
Not over yet.
No, it's not, because Freeze goes down as Ryu comes around the side. Youngbuck tanking tower aggro as he gets polymorphed and taken down, but that'll only keep the pony inside.
Oh, they got him.
And Kassing falls as soon as they catch Hjarnen. Unlimited still chasing around, but Freeze is going to get caught, and Lulex will get the kill to take him down.
I'm running.
Because this game is all over. Number two to H2K.